maestro of ballet music, Tchaikovsky takes listeners into worlds of dreams and fantasy with his scores for Swan Lake, The Sleeping Beauty, and The Nutcracker. Though ballet enjoyed a golden age in the 19th century, the music accompanying the medium was rarely considered first rate, and its reputation lagged behind the sets, choreography, and other elements. But Tchaikovsky relished the chance to capture the dramatic and psychological nuances of these fairy tale worlds, unburdened by symphonic forms. First up was Swan Lake, the tale of Odette, the princess who is turned into a swan by the sorcerer Baron von Rothbart. While visiting his sister at her country house one summer, Tchaikovsky created a short ballet to entertain his nieces called The Lake of Swans, and even demonstrated the steps and pirouettes for his young charges. 4 years later, quite by coincidence, Moscow's Bolshoi Theater commissioned him to write a ballet on this same story. The work was marred by a threadbare production and ragged dancing, and the composer repeatedly clashed with the choreographer. But Tchaikovsky's sumptuous score was recognized by another choreographer, Marius Petipa, who rescued the work in 1895 and set the template for modern-day productions. After the troubles that plagued Swan Lake, 10 years lapsed before the director of Imperial Theaters in St. Petersburg commissioned Tchaikovsky to score a ballet based on the Charles Perrault fairy tale, The Sleeping Beauty. The composer threw himself into the project and, over 40 days, wrote some 30 numbers and nearly 3 hours of music. Tchaikovsky felt it was one of his best works. With choreography by Petipa, the tale begins with Princess Aurora's Sweet 16 party. Then comes the fateful moment when she pricks her finger and falls under a spell, only to be awakened 100 years later by a handsome prince. The relative freedom of ballet allowed Tchaikovsky to be more experimental in his orchestrations. Think of the newly invented celesta in The Nutcracker. It's one of many wondrous sounds in this score, which Tchaikovsky tailored for a younger audience. This is a tale of transformation, with the wooden nutcracker turning into a handsome prince in a kingdom of candy. The ballet suite initially grabbed all the headlines, and in 1892, the CSO gave its U.S. premiere, 2 months before the ballet itself opened in St. Petersburg. But that finally caught on during the mid-20th century, becoming the Christmas perennial it is today.